I appreciate the camaraderie and relationship that our program has with yours, our staff has with yours, and wish you and Rob and your entire staff the best. It really has been an honor to be part of the Catamount family, hockey family, and I certainly don't take for granted how good the relationship between our programs is and the commitment to UVM for hockey. And I also thank and probably everybody thanks Three Brothers for the pizza, and I particularly do want to give a shout out to the Windjammer for sponsoring our team and for being a presenting sponsor and also the sponsor for our tournament, the Windjammer Classic, which I think has quickly become the premier tournament in women's college hockey. Tom O'Connell and Jeff Bushy do a great job for us, and I appreciate everything they do. This is my sixth media day, and it's gone quickly. and frankly, this one feels very much like a new beginning for our program. And there are many reasons for that, but mainly because we have so many new faces between our roster and our staff. And I want to take a second to introduce a few of the new faces that we have in the room. I've got two new assistant coaches. I've got associate head coach Jess Kazumi back there, who comes to us after a year at Ohio State and 6 years at Yale. And a distinguished playing career, which included a couple years with the U.S. national team. And our other assistant coach, Josh Legal, brings 13 years of Division I women's college experience to our program, primarily in the ECAC and in the WCHA, and was most recently at Dartmouth. We've also got a whole new group behind the scenes, and that's going to include another new person when we lose Ryan on Friday. And I do want to give a shout out on top of Alistair's to thank Ryan. We've got a new director of operations, Josh Grazer, who comes to us from Canisius. We've got a new equipment manager, Tyler Potter, who comes to us from the Orlando Solar Bears of the ECHL. And then this summer it was basically just me. And Allison Shepard, our great athletic trainer, and Justin Smith, our strength coach, who were holding down the fort. And so it's been interesting to integrate everybody, but we're off and running, and we've already got an exhibition game under our belt. But of course, the players. We've got eight new players on our roster this year, and I'll talk a little bit about the roster makeup, but I'm not going to talk too much about the freshmen. But when we get off the bus on Saturday in Providence, we're going to have 12 new people, which is almost half the group that will be getting off the bus. So certainly a very different feeling amongst our team. And before I go any further, though, I do want to acknowledge and thank the seven seniors who graduated last year, because they were very much the foundation of the progress that we've made in the program over the 5 years that I've been here. They were my first recruiting class. They bookended their careers with the two best years in our program's history, with the appearances in the hockey semifinals in their freshman and senior years. And frankly, I personally learned a lot from that group, and really, for that matter, all the players who played here over the past 5 years. And I think where we are now and where I am as a Division I coach has a lot to do with those 5 years. That said, this is a very different team that I think can build on what we accomplished last year. We did graduate those seven players, and I think it'd be normal to assume that there are big holes to fill. We still return a lot of vital pieces from last year's successful team. I really feel that we're strong in all three phases of the game. We returned two excellent goalies in Melissa Black and Sydney Scobie. We returned five of the six defensemen who played regular shifts, including Hockey East All-Star Taylor Willard, and so I guess that's a little different. We've got six defensemen who are juniors and seniors, and we return our top three scorers from last year's team in sophomore Ev-Audrey Picard, juniors Alyssa Grecki and Sana Balkama. But I think perhaps, maybe most importantly, we have a group that's positive, they're hardworking, they're completely committed to the program's values. And this is something that we've really stressed over the past couple of years, and this team, frankly, is right up there with the championship teams I've coached in my career in terms of living out the culture that's required to be successful. We have had a completely whirlwind preseason between new coaches coming in, new players, recruiting, everything. But I really like the way we played on Saturday, rather on Sunday versus Montreal. And I do feel that we'll be ready for our regular season opener Sunday against Providence. I want to just take a minute to highlight a couple of important dates and aspects of our schedule. We might have the most challenging non-conference schedule in the country. We've got 9 non-conference games, and seven of them are against top teams that are ranked in the top 11 of the USCHO poll. So I'm sure someone will ask me why I did such a thing. And those are, in order that we play them, Quinnipiac, Clarkson, either Colgate or Minnesota Duluth in our tournament, and Minnesota. 4 of the games being against Clarkson and Minnesota are against the teams that account for the last six national championships. So we're going to get measured. And I feel like that's the benefit of playing a tough schedule, is that we're going to get a chance to compete with and measure ourselves against some of the other best teams in the country, the ones that aren't in Hockey East. And I think we will be better prepared for a very challenging Hockey East schedule. And at least the games are spaced out so that we're not playing our first 6 games against these teams. They're in consecutive months. I do want to recognize and give people a heads up about our Windjammer Classic, which I think the reason that it's a premier tournament is it's the only one that features a team from each of the D1 conferences. So we've got Minnesota Duluth coming in, who's I think ranked 5th right now, and they're from the WCHA. We have Colgate, which is the first one receiving votes. They're from the ECAC, and we have RIT joining us from College Hockey America. Of course, Pack the Gut will again be a highlight for us. It's going to be our last home weekend of the year, and we play UConn on a Friday night, and certainly be a meaningful game. And just finally, I really legitimately foresee this as being the most competitive season in women's hockey East history. I don't know how it's all going to shake out, but I'm positive that it's going to be closer than it's ever been, and we've already seen an upset, or at least by the preseason rankings, where Merrimack went to BU and beat them last week in the first game of the Hockey East regular season. But we're going to be ready to go for our regular season, which opens with 2 important Hockey East games this Sunday, October 1st at Providence, and then the following Saturday, October 7th at UConn. So, with that, open for questions.
For both of you, what's the biggest difference, I guess, when you look at this year's team compared to last year's team?
Well, I think as Jim mentioned, you know, we have 12 new faces on our roster, and I think there'll be a lot of, you know, relying on the leadership and the returning players to help bring the first year players along, and they've done a great job so far. That's probably the biggest difference. And I also say the depth of our forward group is the best it's been.
I would echo that. I think the depth of our forward group, we do have 5 freshman forwards here. They bring different skills to the table than the kids that graduated. We had a lot of grit, a lot of shot blockers. We didn't have as many points throughout that whole group as I think the potential of this group has. Of course, they're freshmen, and it's going to take a little time for them to gel. But I feel that that's probably the biggest difference. That similar to Kevin, where you talked about changing their style of play last year, we did too, to a more puck possession style, which was effective in controlling the game. And I feel that this group that we have now can take that to another level.